Jai Sri Krishna. Welcome you all to my channel. Today's RHCSA exam question is, extend the swap space with 1 GB. Don't remove the existing swap. It should be available even after reboot. Let's start. Login to the root account. Type swap on -s command to check the status of swap memory. File name with path dev dm-1 and memory size is 2 GB. By free-m command, we can verify the status of the total usable space of swap memory along with the physical memory. Now, type lsblk command to check the status of the disk and partitions. VDB is our target disk to create swap partition. Type fdisk/dep/vdb. Type n for new. Type e for extended partition. Hit enter. Hit enter again. Type +1g for 1 GB space. Type P to print or show the partition which we have just configured. OK. Perfect. Type T to assign a hex code. Type the code number 82 to change the partition type extended to Linux swap. Type W to save the changes. Type partprobe /dev/vdv or reboot the system to instant implement the changes. The partprobe command is used to inform the operating system to partition table changes. Type lsblk command again. Our swap partition is showing here. Now type mkswap /dev/vdv1 command to format it with swap file type. OK, done. Type swap on /dev/vdv1 command to activate the swap partition. Type swap on -s to check the present status of swap memory. /dev/vdv1 file name has been added with the memory size of 1 GB space. Now type blkid /dev/vdv1 command to show the UUID of this partition. This is the UUID of this partition. Now copy the UUID. Type vim /etc/fstab command to add an entry in fstab file. Paste the UUID here. Watch it attentively. Save and exit. Type mount-a to mount or remount all entry within fstab file, or if we did anything wrong, it will give an error message. OK, all is well. Now it will be available even after system reboot. Type -m command to check the status of total swap space. Yes, the swap space is now extended to 3 GB by adding with 1 GB additional space without removing existing swap, and it will be available even after system reboot. our question has been resolved successfully. Hope you like this video. Please like, share and subscribe my channel to boost me up to create more knowledgeful videos. Thank you.